Hello, vinyl community, and hello, John. Today I'm going to honor your channel, JB's Vinyl and Cassettes, because John has reached a big milestone. He passed 100 subscribers. And to celebrate that, he has thrown out the contest. And the contest contains two questions. Two questions. Pretty easy. What is the best musical investment and what is the worst? I will answer those, but before that, I have to say that you have to check up John's channel. I have the link below. Click on it, subscribe to him and watch him. He's pretty funny and he has a wide spectrum in his musical taste. And he's a pretty funny guy because he can't sit still. I think he has to have some kind of diagnosis, because especially his right arm, it's going around and hits the screen. Fuck shit, it freaks me out. At least, just kidding. I like you. You are a cool guy. And so, back to the questions. Best and the worst. I will start with the worst, because worst buys you do all the time, especially if you are record collector as I am. When I buy online, I always do the research before I hit the buy button, because you never know. It's pointless to waste money on stuff that you don't like. But when I go to a record store, I don't have all the knowledge of the records that I buy. And sometimes you buy music that you don't like, or it doesn't fit your taste perfectly. So then you just pass them on or give them away, or do something else with it, like I did with this one. This is a guy called Thomas Ledin and a record called Tillfälligheternas spel from 1990. It's a record that doesn't fit my musical taste. He's not a bad artist at all. He has many number ones here in Sweden, at least, and he's selling pretty good, but it's not really my cup of tea. So instead of throwing this away because nobody else wanted it, so you can do something else with it, like I did. As this is something I do in my spare time, I paint. So these are good canvas. It works. And you have the hole there, so you can just put it on the wall. Okay, that's a worst one. That turned out to be a good one. And one of the best. I have many really good ones, but I want to show something a little different. I have a 7-inch single here. Lying Eyes, with the Swedish hard rock band Europe. You know, Europe with a famous tune, The Final Countdown. This single was the first official tune to be released from their second album, Wings of Tomorrow, in 1984. But just when they were supposed to let it out, they changed their minds and withdrew it and changed it to Stormbringer. Well, things like that can happen. And as the story tells, there should be only 200 copies out. Nobody knows for real. I think it's less, because I haven't seen any on the market. And there's, I think, one at Discogs at the moment, and it's pretty pricey. So check it up if you want. And on the backside, we have Dreamer. So this is pretty cool on the Hot Records. Okay, that was my contribution for your contest. I hope you enjoy it. And stay safe. Keep them spinning. Fridens.